just a closer walk with thee. Granted, Jesus is my plea. Daily walking close to thee. Let it be, dear Lord, let it be.
Prayers that are deep in our hearts. You know the longings for which there are no words. And you know the cries of your people throughout the world. Those affected by violence, cruelty, hatred, and greed. Come, Lord Jesus, bring your peace. And guide your people to be attentive to you, that trusting in your love, we might love others. Amen.
Lift up to the Lord
all those ways in which we've gone astray, claimed for ourselves knowledge which we do not have, power that should not be ours. trusting in the forgiveness of God. Now, my friends, that the Lord Jesus loves you, that you are forgiven. Thanks be to God.
Let's pray. Prions le Seigneur. Ô tendre Père, Créateur du ciel et de la terre, le Dieu Tout-Puissant, Omnipotent, Omnicréant, nous élevons nos cœurs devant toi, Seigneur. Les jours saints où tous les chrétiens se réunissent pour t'adorer, ô Seigneur, nous invoquons ta présence divine entre nous. Nous voulons que tu sois manifeste au milieu de nous. Car tu as dit, les vrais adorateurs m'adoreront en vérité et en esprit. Que tu sois manifeste dans les chansons, dans nos prières, dans la prédication. Ô Seigneur. Tu es le Dieu d'amour. Nous prions pour ceux qui sont dans les désastres. Nous prions pour ceux qui sont dans les événements horribles de Touéry. Que ta main protectrice soit au milieu de tous ceux qui t'invoquent. Car tu as dit, celui qui m'invoque sera sauvé. Seigneur Dieu de l'univers, sois élevé, sois exalté, sois adoré, mon Dieu, mon roi. Ô Seigneur, nous te remercions pour les guérisons instantanées de ceux qui t'évoquent. Nous prions pour ceux qui sont dans les hôpitaux maintenant. Nous prions pour ceux qui sont au cours des voyages, les voyageurs qui s'en vont ça et là. Protège tous les attroupements des gens. Nous prions pour les Congos. Nous te disons merci puisque tu es au milieu de nous. Bénis la journée d'aujourd'hui, bénis tes saints. Que ton Esprit Saint nous invoque, soit au milieu de nous dans ces lieux, dès maintenant et à jamais. Au nom de notre Seigneur Jésus-Christ, nous prions. Amen.
The reading this morning is from Colossians 3rd chapter. So, if you have been raised with Christ, seek the things that are above, where Christ is, seated at the right hand of God. Set your minds on things that are above, not on things that are on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, who is your life, is revealed, then you also will be revealed with him in glory. Put to death, therefore, whatever in you is earthly: fornication, impurity, passion, evil desire, and greed, which is idolatry. On account of these, the wrath of God is coming on those who are disobedient. These are the ways you also once followed when you were living that life. But now you must get rid of all such things: anger, wrath, malice, slander, and abusive language from your mouth. Do not lie to one another, seeing that you have stripped off the old self with its practices and have clothed yourself with the new self, which is being renewed in knowledge according to the image of its creator. In that renewal, there is no longer Greek and Jew, circumcised and uncircumcised, barbarian, Scythian, slave, and free. But Christ is all and in all. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
So what did St. Paul mean about clothing ourselves in the new self, renewed in the knowledge according to the image of God? Could it be that God really has offered us hope, that we can live in new ways, that we can find renewal after countless defeats and hopelessness? Could it be that God's power is already at work in us for this transformation? Now, for a long time, we've neglected the power of God described in this passage to our detriment. And as the old song, which we didn't sing that well this morning, says, when you keep your mind stayed on Jesus, all of this is possible. When we keep our hearts and minds focused on God, There is a transforming power that works within us. When Methodism got started, a crazy Anglican priest named John Wesley had a few things to say. And one of them was about this passage. He said, "You can be new. You can be transformed. You can live a different life." He didn't use these words. "If you keep your mind stayed on Jesus, if you keep focused on the relationship with God, not just about God, but on who God actually is, the great mystery that is present to us even when we're not thinking." Of course, we go astray from the image of God that's been placed within us, the goodness of creation in us, by chasing after less than who God is. We chase after this, after that. We chase after certain other kinds of knowledge and other kinds of stuff and living, and we do not stay on Jesus. But Jesus is faithful to us. His love is enough to enable us once again to find that holiness of love, to allow us to discover within ourselves newness of self. Christ dwelling in us through the Spirit opens us up through faith to a new way of living, aligning God's will inwardly and outwardly changing how we live. And what do we say of this in practical terms? Well, a friend came to me saying that the friend was temporarily overcome with a great numbing darkness, probably due to stress of caring for someone else. But the bright morning sunshine and gentle presence of flowers opened this friend to return of inner joy and peace and belovedness and equilibrium. It allowed my friend to re-enter the love of God and that grow in that centeredness. Another friend who long suffered with inner pain and darkness recently told me that it seems to have passed as the friend has discovered an overwhelming sense of gratitude that leads to joy and peace and lightness of spirit. When I was diagnosed with cancer, there was first a sense of foreboding. I was concerned to, as they say, put my affairs in order and ready myself for death. I found I was short on patience and irritable, just ask my family. And yet going through surgery and treatment, somewhere in there, even before I had a sense that I might be a survivor of cancer, there was a lightheartedness, a freedom, a joy, which made me, I hope, a little less impatient and irritable. You'll have to check with Ingrid later on that. I'm also reminded of an elderly woman with considerable pain and discomfort from arthritis and joint degeneration. I think not a day goes by that she doesn't experience some sort of physical discomfort. And yet a light shines in her and love for those around her. She speaks of loving grace and embraces life and other people, irrespective of how challenging they can be. And each of these circumstances points to newness of the self in Christ, in ways in which the Holy Spirit working in us enables us to move toward holiness in love, to live into a new goodness that Christ offers us. St. Paul notes that this newness cuts through the usual barriers between people. No longer Greek or Jew, circumcised or uncircumcised, barbarian or Scythian, slave or free, man or woman. We are all one in the renewed image of God. It doesn't mean we cease to be different. But we are renewed in the image of God, and it enables us to live in the holiness of love so that we are united in Christ first and foremost. And our social relationships are transformed. That we become able to act differently, to live differently, to show the face of Christ to the world around us. Have you experienced newness of life? Have you experienced the love of Christ so that you are transformed within by the Spirit? Has the fruit of the Spirit revealed itself in you? Have you allowed Christ to take root in your soul? Have your social relationships changed so that you can embrace even difficult folks in love? Newness of life is available to all of us. It starts with the appreciation that God is with us. The mystery of God is present to us, that we are not alone, even if we cannot prove God, even if we cannot explain God, even if we do not understand, that there is a presence, transcendent presence that's with us. And that presence is love. And embracing that, we become free from having to defend ourselves against the world. Of course, we're not instantly little angels. In fact, we're probably not going to be angels at all. But Christ working in us through the Spirit will set us free so that we can let go of the chains of our old habits and thinking and feeling. The power of God shines forth in peace and gentleness. We discover more generosity and self-control and patience in ourselves. We may even be surprised in these changes, thinking nothing of them, we might grab again for the old patterns of life that have kept us in slavery. And still Christ calls us to newness of life, to our own souls yearning for freedom and joy. We can open again to Christ's love. And this process all works when we're stayed on Jesus. Stayed on Jesus. How does that work? When you were in love as a young person, you remember being totally focused on your beloved, I suspect, thinking of nothing else and just being totally focused. If we learn to practice that degree of love and attention with God, we stayed on Jesus and we are transformed. We will do whatever it takes. And so, friends, in these times of troubles, of anxiety and anger and worry, of self-hatred, and of way too much hatred and bitterness toward others, don't despair. Don't beat yourself up. Instead, turn toward the promise of love and grace in Christ. Allow Christ to touch you inwardly and set you free. Practice thankfulness and praise God. These are the two best lubricants of liberation, thankfulness and praise. If you've ever had a challenging moment in a relationship, you may have found that saying good things about the person who just irritated the hell out of you changes how that works, doesn't it? When you can praise that person, all the rest of the stuff kind of fades to the side, and love returns. Astounding as it is, it's even more outwardly amazing in what it does for us in the world. Because if we are transformed from within, then that transformation beckons others to look for it as well, to reach out to others, to experience this love for themselves, to look for the transformation. And this is how the church, the body of Christ, grows. This is how we thrive in our mission of love. This is how each of us can bear Christ to the world, and how we are renewed in the image of God. So will you join this wonderful transformation?
Thank you.
And now, my friends, you get to get up and move for the Lord as we bring our tithes and offerings to God. To his table. Everyone is welcome at this table because Christ has promised to be present to us in this food and in this time. And so I invite you to prepare yourselves to meet Jesus, to be open to the presence of God. Gluten-free is on my left, just ask for it.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is all right, a good, a joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth.
Oh, Lord, you formed us in your image and breathed into us the breath of life. When we turned away and our love failed, your love remained steadfast. You delivered us from captivity and made covenant to be our sovereign God, speaking to us through your prophets, who looked for the day when justice would roll down like waters and righteousness like an ever-flowing stream. And so with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join in their unending hymn. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Holy are you, and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ.
Your Spirit anointed him to preach good news to the poor, to proclaim release to the captives and recovering of sight to the blind, to set at liberty those who are oppressed, and to announce that the time has come when you will save your people. He healed the sick and fed the hungry and ate with sinners. And by the baptism of his suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church, delivering us from slavery to sin and death, and making with us a new covenant by water and the Spirit.
On the night in which he gave himself up for us, he took the bread, gave thanks to you, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When the supper was over, he took the cup, gave thanks to you, gave it to his disciples and said, "Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant poured out for you and for many for forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me."
And so, in remembrance of these, your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice, in union with Christ's offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here and on this gift of bread and wine. Make them before us the body and the blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world, until Christ come in final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet through your Son, Jesus Christ, with his Holy Spirit, in your holy church. All honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now, forever. Amen.
Amen.
Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen. The bread of heaven, that you may be fed.
Amen.
The cup of blessing, that you may be blessed. All things are ready, you may come forward. The body of Christ.
The body of Christ. Given for you. The body of Christ. Let us pray together. Eternal God, we give you thanks for this holy ministry
which you have given yourself to us.
Great blood maker of the world and the strongest
of your spirit.
We give our service for all this. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Friends, go forth filled with the Holy Spirit. Carry Jesus in your heart. Stay stayed on Jesus, and the world will know love. Amen.